Now, OK, we hear a lot from the Labor Party and the Greens when it comes to the need to get women into senior positions in politics. And we hear endlessly from them about what they call the Liberal Party's women problem. So that's their words. What about their actions? Well, we know they don't call off the ferals and the activists when they viciously target female Liberal politicians who are specifically targeted by unions and Get Up and the like. Just ask Nicole Flint. Now, Liberal MPs have to endure vile abuse from the feral left if they're women, but it's the Liberal Party's problem, apparently, that this drives some of these women away from politics. And last night, in the New South Wales upper house, we got another example of the left saying one thing and doing another. The Liberal Party proposed one of its own, Natasha Maclaren Jones, for the prestigious job of President of the Upper House, a role that puts her in charge of proceedings and adds $100,000 to her salary. She got the job in a tight and contentious ballot. But look at what happened when she tried to do that job.
I seek the call. Mr. Clark, I seek the call. I seek the call.
I call this House to order and I ask the Honourable Peter Primrose to resume his seat immediately.
Inspirational stuff, isn't it? Hope the kids were out of the room. Labor and the Greens were not going to accept her as president. They bullied her. Instead, they'd found a disaffected Liberal man, Matthew Mason Cox, who decided he was happy to shaft his party's choice, take the job and pocket the money. So he is now president, courtesy of Labor and the Greens, who were happy to snatch away a senior political job from a Liberal woman in order to promote a man just to make political mischief.
Just wonder why Labor and the Greens thought it was okay to support a Liberal male over a Liberal female.
Yep, that's Labor and the Greens and the so-called women problem in the Liberal Party. It took a Liberal bloke, of course, to make this shambles work, but that man, Matthew Mason Cox, will now be expelled from the New South Wales Liberal Party. What an unedifying display of hypocrisy and political bastardry, all funded by taxpayers, of course. Just remember games like this every time Labor mentions the Liberals' women problem.